Hi, and welcome to the Word of the Week. This week's word is vulnerability, and it was suggested by Gina Barnhart. So, when we think about vulnerability, maybe this is a really great one for a martial arts instructor to talk about. Because when we talk about self-defense, we're always talking about if you're in a situation where someone's attacking you, especially someone bigger or stronger, you want to go for those vulnerable points, those points that are easily injured, right? That's very difficult to defend against. So targets like the eyes, the throat, the groin, the knees, right? These are the targets that, especially if I'm teaching self-defense to women, I'm going to tell them these are the spots that you want to strike because they are vulnerable to your opponent. And also, I'll teach people how to defend those spots because if they're vulnerable for someone else, they're vulnerable for you as well. Right? However, martial arts coaching is just one of the things that I do. Really, my main emphasis is helping people to develop into better people. Martial arts is just one of the tools I use. So in my role as a mentor, my role as a life coach, vulnerability has a completely different kind of connotation. See, in martial arts, we're thinking about these are the spots that we want to attack. These are the spots we want to defend. In our development, vulnerability is a crucial component to our achievement and to our growth. You see, in order to grow, you have to make yourself vulnerable. You have to open yourself up. You have to put yourself in a position where it's possible that you're going to get hurt. But only by doing this can you make the necessary steps to move forward in your life. See, so many people spend time trying to protect themselves, and they hold themselves in to protect themselves from being hurt. Right? So if you hold your heart too close, if you don't open your heart and take the risk that it might be broken, then you're probably never really going to find love. Right? If you are afraid of making decisions that could expose yourself to ridicule or to other things where you become vulnerable, you put yourself out there for the world. If you don't do those things, then how can you expect to have a global effect? How can you create that kind of change if you're not willing to put yourself out into that kind of a platform? So the processes are actually kind of similar. The ideas are very similar, that in warfare, you have a fort, and you get inside that fort, and if you're in that fort and you're locked all up nice and tight, no one can get in to get you, but it's also hard to get out to get them. So in martial arts, we talk about this concept that when you open a gate, you have to open a gate to attack. You have to open up, and that action of opening up to go out creates an opening in you. So in order to do anything, we really do have to make ourselves vulnerable. So don't necessarily look at vulnerability as a liability. It's actually an ability. It's what's going to enable you. It's going to be what's going to give you the opportunity to grow, but only by opening yourself up and taking that chance. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this week's lesson, and we'll see you next week.